गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आवर सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल, चैप्टर नंबर 3, क्लास 10. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स दैट इज टोटली रिलेटेड टू मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. Why? Because the metals and non-metals we are extracting from ores. So we have to knowledge about ores. From which ores we will collect a metal. Okay, so we will start. What was the difference between minerals and ores? This is our first topic. In that, these are naturally occurring chemical substances obtained from earth crust by mining. Minerals, that is naturally occurring chemical substance that we are found, that we are collecting from nature by the process of mining. When we mining the field soil, then after we get some precious rock and chemical substance, that is called mineral, that is naturally occurring substance. All minerals are not ores, and the minerals that we are getting from nature, they doesn't get in a form of ore. Means all minerals are not in a form of ores. But what is ores? Ores are those minerals from which metals can be extracted profitably and conveniently. What was ores? Ores is a mixture of pure and impure substance. In that, metals and some impurities are found in a form of rock. From that we are extracting metal in which substance, that is called ore. All ores are minerals. We will say all ores are minerals. Why? Because we get metals from the ores. That's why all the ores are is minerals. But all minerals are not ore. Metallurgy. This is a branch of science in which we study about how to extract metals and non-metals from its ore. The extractions of metals from their ore by various processes is called metallurgy. So there are so many processes from which we collect metals and non-metals. Here we are talking about metals that we are collecting through their ores. That various process is called metallurgy. Occurrence of metals. Matlab, how we occur metal, how we will found metal. Least reactive metals occurs in free state. Means some metals are we are getting in a free state, like gold, silver, platinum, copper. These are all found in a free state. Why? Because they are least reactive. So we doesn't found mostly in ore forms, because it doesn't react with every metal. That's why. Now reactive metals exist in combined state. Means that metals that are more reactive. Yesterday I show you one whole chart about reactive, more reactive and less reactive chart. Potassium is most reactive metal, and gold, platinum is least reactive metals. Yes, in previous video we already studied that. So these reactive metals like potassium, sodium, then copper, then calcium, these are reactive metals that are found in a combined state. So they are never found in a free state. That's why we have to extract them through the ore. So there are some properties of ore and some names from which we get that metal. Now iron. Iron is a metal, Fe2O3, that is hematite. Hematite is a ore. From that we are extracting iron, Fe3O4, that is magnetite. So there are two type of ores from which we get iron. Which one? That hematite and magnetite. These are two names of ores from which we get iron, like copper, copper pyrites and copper glands. These two ores from which we get copper. So what is copper pyrites? CuFeSO2 and Cu2S. So these two ores from which we get copper. Aluminum, we are extracting aluminum by bauxites and corundum, that is Al2O3.2H2O, here point means multiply, Al2O3. So these two ores from which we get aluminum. Mercury, cinnabar is a type of ore from which we get mercury. Sodium chloride, NaCl, from NaCl we are getting sodium. Lead, galena, from which we get lead. Pb is the symbol of leads. Why? Because his scientific name was plumbic. Pb, that is called lead. Now, alloy is a one type of ore, one type of man-made ore, we will see. Say that from alloy, when we combine metals and non-metals, two or three elements, to form a new type of a compound, that is called alloy. Alloy are homogeneous mixture of two or more metals, one of them can be non-metals also. Means we are using two or more metals, but sometimes we are using one of them non-metal also, like brass is an alloy of copper and zinc, bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. So when we combine two metals to form new type of alloy, that is brass and bronze, this is the example of alloy. Amalgam is an homogeneous mixture of a metal and mercury. Means when metal and mercury will be mixed with each other, they form amalgam. Example, sodium amalgam containing NaHg. Okay, so here Na is metal, Hg is mercury. When we mix a metal and mercury, they forms an amalgam. Now, calcination and roasting, these are the two process we are using in extraction of ore. First we will see the whole chart, how we will extract ores, metals from the ores. Then we will study what is calcination and what is roasting. So see here, this is a chart, steps involved in the extractions of metal from ores. How, what was the steps from we extract metals from ores? First we getting ore, then we have to concentration of ore, means we have to take an ore in a powder form. Then there are three processes, X, Y and Z. First process X, first we have to take ore in a concentration of ore, then metals of high reactivity, we will extract metals of high reactivity, means that metal which is very highly reactive, first we extract that metal. Then electrolysis of molten ore, means first we have to convert into molten state and then we will electrolysis. Why? Because in molten state electric current will be passed, that's why from electrolysis process we will get pure metal. Another step, why? There are two type, here there are two type of process. First calcination, second roasting. First we have to take concentration of ore, then metals of medium reactivity. Okay, means a metal that is not a least and not a most reactive metals, that are in medium reactivity, for that we use this process. Then if the ore in a carbonate ores, in a form of carbonate ores, then we have to follow this method. If the ore in a sulfide ore, in a form of sulfide ore, then we have to use this method. Only one steps will be different. What? If the carbonate ores will be there, then we have to use calcination process. If sulfide ore will be there, then we have to use roasting process. Then same, oxide of metal, then reduction to metal, then purification of metal. these steps are including here also oxide of metal reduction to metal purification of metal. Means when medium reactive metals, when we are extracting metals that are in medium reactive nature, then we have to use these two methods, in which if the metal were in a the ore was in a carbonate ore in a form of, then we have calcination process. If they are in sulfide ore, then we have to use roasting process. Now last and least, metals of low reactivity, means that metals which are already a low reactive metals. We all know mostly they are found in a free state, but some are not found in a free state. Then we have to use this method. First it was mostly in sulfide ore, then same roasting, then we get roasting means we have to roast the metal, then refine the metal, we get a pure metal. So these are the process and the charts, the steps that were involving in the extraction of metal by its ore. Then we will see what is calcination and what is roasting. These are two method in which we have to heat the ore, means the process of heating ore in the absence of air. And in calcination the air is absent, means we are heating ores but air is absent, then that process is called calcination. But in roasting, the process in which also we have to heat the ore but in the presence of oxygen, that process is called roasting. Calcination process is used to convert carbonate ores into oxide, and roasting process is used to convert sulfide ore in oxide. We will study a scene already seen in chart, carbon for to convert carbonate ores in oxide of metals, we have to use calcination. To convert sulfide ores into oxide of metals, to we use roasting process. So understand what is calcination and what is roasting. What is calcination? The process in which we are heating ores in the absence of air, and it was used to convert carbonate ores into oxide. But roasting, what is roasting? The process in which we are heating an ore in the presence of oxygen. It was used in the it was used to convert sulfide ores into oxide of metals. So understand what is calcination and what is roasting. So we will go our last, we are study about electrolysis. What is electrolysis? That is electrolytic refining. This is also process in which we are using solutions to extract metals by its ore. What we are doing in that? Metals like copper, zinc, aluminium, these are purified by electrolytic refining method. Impure metals act as anode, pure metals act as cathode. Soluble salts of metal act as electrolytic. When electric current passed, impure metal changes into metal ions which gain electrons at cathode to form pure metal. The impurities are left behind anode mud. Means in which this is, we will taken two metals, one is impure metal and second is pure metal. What happens when we pass the electricity through in here? It was a solution of salt solution in which electric current will be passed, conduct easily. Then we will pass the electric current through anode. There what was here? There impure metal. Then when electric current passed through this anode, the pure metal will be lose the electron, means the this metal will, impure metal will lose the electrons of pure metal, and it will collected at cathode, and the impurities that was left behind the mud in a form of mud, that is called anode mud. And at cathode we get a pure metal. This process is called electrolytic refining. So these are the three process from which we will extract metals by its ore. Now last, corrosion. We already studied in previous chapter also. What is corrosion? Rusting of iron, red brownish on copper. So ग्रे कलर एट कॉपर कोटिंग विद द सर्फेस ऑफ कॉपर दैट इज ऑल्सो करोजन. Corrosion is the process by rusting by any kind of metal or alloy due to the presence of moisture and air in its surroundings. Means it is a type of rusting a metal by the process or by the involution of moisture and air from our surrounding. That is called corrosion. Some examples here are given. Silver turns black due to the formation of Ag2, means Ag2S, silver sulfide. Means we are wearing silvers and golds, right? So when we are using wearing a silver metal, then after some time the shiny surface is covered with a black surface, it covered with black, then why it is due to the formation of Ag2S, that is silver sulfide. So that exposed to air, that was by the reaction of silver and oxygen, means by its air. So it converts silvers into black, that is called a corrosion. Copper react with oxygen, moisture and carbon dioxide, it converts the color will be changed of the copper, their color is green, means the copper is fully coated with a green color. So that is an example of corrosion. And why it was converted into green color? Because of copper carbonate, means it forms copper carbonate on the surface of copper. Iron, when exposed to moisture, we all know iron was rusting. In Hindi we are saying jang lagna, right? So that is another example of corrosion. How we will prevent this corrosion? So means how we will save to doesn't rust the iron. So what we are doing, we are applying oiling, greasing, painting, galvanization. There are so many methods to prevent corrosion. So we are using that method to prevent corrosion.